that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts you in a situation where it's where you're being wronged, and there are so many ways that people wrong other people, but when you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watchful over what is happening, how do you conduct yourself? So it is the thinking well of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that decides how a person reacts to a calamity that befalls him. And this is exactly what Yusuf alayhi salam showed in this test, that innahu rabbi ahsana mathwaya, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my Lord, ahsana mathwaya. And then you go on. He was put in prison, wrongfully. And then she says, that if Yusuf does not do what I want, then he will be put in prison. What does Yusuf alayhi salam say? He says, رَبِّ السِّجْنَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ. That, oh Allah, the prison is better for me from what they call me to, from what they want me to do. Oh Allah, I'd rather be in prison. Even we know that the Prophet ﷺ later commented on this, and he said, had my brother Yusuf said that I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for al-afiyah, I ask Allah to save me, because it's, and the Prophet in a hadith, he says, there's nothing better to ask of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala better than al-afiyah, for someone to be safe, for someone to have safety in his health, in his way of life, that we do not look for these circumstances, that we don't say, I'd rather be in prison. So what is better to say than saying, I'd rather be in prison, than ask Allah al-afiyah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for al-afiyah. This came in the hadith also. It also came in the hadith that one of the Sahaba said, oh Allah, every punishment that you're saving for me later, bring it to me now. And then he became very sick. Very sick, up to the point that the Sahaba complained to the Prophet. And when the Prophet asked him, he says, what is your matter? And then he tells him that this is what I said. And then he says, no, it's not good to ask that, because Allah is Ar-Rahim. Allah forgives. In the ayah, وَقُلْ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ وَارْحَمْ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ, that say, O Prophet of Allah, my Lord, اغْفِرْ وَارْحَمْ, forgive and have mercy. Indeed, you're the best of those that have mercy. But sometimes the test comes. Whether you look for it or not look for it, it's a reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us for. Allah says, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةِ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, that He created life and death to test us, to see who does the best amongst us. Allah says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, indeed we will test you, whether you like it or not. أَلِفْ لَا مِيمْ, أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. That do the people think that they will say we believe and that they will not be tested? So it comes with iman that a person is tested, and it's with the level of iman of the person that the test will be. If a person has a high iman, then he will be tested with more severe tests. And who was tested with a more severe test than our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And we know in the Ahd, in the time of Mecca, the tests were severe. That the Muslims were being persecuted, some of them were being killed in very, very severe ways. And we know the story of Sumayyah, radiallahu anha, and the other Sahaba, such as Julaybi as well, such as Khubayb, I mean, So many Sahabas were tested in ways that perhaps to us we can't even imagine the difficulty of. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the time of Mecca, we know that he lost his dear wife Khadija radiallahu anha, and he also lost his uncle Abu Talib, who used to support him. And that was unimaginable grief for him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we can find in the Sirah exactly how the details of how he reacted, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sadness that some say that the Prophet, there was a time that he lost track of where he was going as he was walking because of how grieved he was. And we know that they were boycotted as well, to the point that some of them were eating their clothes. And at a time also when the wahi was delayed, and there was not anything that was more shaky to the Prophet than this. Why? Because the people of Mecca started telling the Prophet that Allah hates you now. Allah has forsaken you. Where is the revelation? 6 months. No revelation. And the Muslims are being shaken. Why has the wahi stopped? And as all of this grief is going on, Allah tells the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wa al-Duha, wal-layli idha saja. And Allah is taking an oath that ma wada'aka rabbuka wa ma qala, that your Lord has not forsaken you, wa ma qala, and he does not hate you. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَىٰ, that the Akhirah is better for you than this life. فَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَىٰ, Allah will give you and you will be pleased with what He gives you. And then Allah asks the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أَلَمْ يَجِدِكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَىٰ, that didn't Allah find you an orphan? And he gave you shelter. Didn't Allah give you shelter? وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى, and he found you lost, astray, not on the right path. فَهَدَى, and didn't he guide you? وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى, and didn't he find you destitute, poor, with nothing? فَأَغْنَى, and he made you rich. So it's sometimes it's easy to forget the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us in the light of tests. And it's good to remember that the status of a slave does not get elevated, but when Allah tests him, and he responds to the test in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ gives him ni'mah, because there are two kinds of tests. there's the test for what we perceive to be good, which is bi-ni'mah, which is health, wealth.